What's your name again?
Mocha, the creator.
Mocha, the creator.
Like the English creator, like God, I never asked you to call me God, I just asked you to respect the creator in me. So I am a mother of five children, right? And I'm working on my first book, it's called Mocha, How Ghetto. Parenting your tribe while raising your inner child, right? And this is my soapbox, if you will. So I've noticed a few things between classroom life and raising children. This is my first year in the classroom, right? I teach eighth grade, English language arts. And I have a theory about daddy wounds and mommy wounds. Daddy wounds look like slick mouths with overly sensitive emotions, right? They have those quick wit in that mouth, but they're always the first ones ready to fight somebody if you say the wrong thing, right? I believe that this is because they process their emotions through a feminine filter, so they slick tongue like they mamas, but they lack the ability to fully process the emotion at hand. That's where they daddy come in to help them, right? Mommy wounds look like emotional vacancies, right? So it comes off like an attitude problem, but really it's just a little bit of anxiety and all they need is a hug, right? Have you ever hugged a child that's super duper angry and they just melted in your arms? That's all they needed, right? So imagine a generation that lacks fathers with depressed mothers who lack the capacity or the energy to be present. Of course our relationships will be messed up, right? So America owes us reparations for the war on drugs, if nothing else, because that's where its roots lie, right? So we are all a group of occupational orphans, but what we see now is that the gap has gotten big between old and young, right? But it's the same shit. Can I cuss? Forgive me.
Yeah,
sorry.
You sure,
it's
yeah,
just
yeah,
a different toilet.
Yeah,
it's
good.
Just a different toilet, right? We were the latchkey kids, right? We were the latchkey kids. We went home with that key around our neck, and then we let ourselves in, and then the television programming let us, that's what helped raise us. Right? The television programming was bringing back to hip hop, right? So it's not necessarily that there is a death that's taking place in hip hop. It's not what it is. It's always been the same. It's just that now we really gone. Because when we at home, we really gone. Yeah, go ahead, right? So while our children are growing up, they aren't necessarily being raised, but neither were we. That's why we're having a hard time becoming mothers. That's why we're having a hard time connecting with the fathers, right? This is nothing new. So we have to be careful not to judge the youth because they are only reflections of us, right? And when you really look at it, right? When you really, really look at it, we all the same and we all in this together. But it's time to start some healing, right? It's time to start throwing around healing languages so that we can progress. That's not what's happening here. If you don't mind, I'm going to read now a piece of my book. Is that okay? Right on. Were you raised or did you just grow up? I suppose the easiest way to come to the conclusion in the matter is to examine the decision-making of the individual, as we are nothing more than the summation of the decisions that we've made in life. Those who were raised move with a certain confidence, while those who grew up sometimes find themselves stuck, frozen by the fear of yet another failed decision, and it's difficult to develop confidence in your decision-making ability when you do not trust yourself to succeed, right? 14 years into motherhood and three baby daddies was all that it took me to realize and recognize that I had been operating with a wounded inner child. But I'm grateful because some people never recognize this. Some people never take the time to check on that kid that they spent their entire childhood running from. I kept running into the same demons that I was running from. Each one of my children was a different call to action, and I was slow to get the lesson. It's because I was avoiding myself, right? Emotional vacancy, right? I was avoiding myself. I would use my relationships to distract me from acknowledging that little girl that felt abandoned for over three decades, not recognizing that I was abandoning myself, with each relationship and putting them in the position to abandon me and their seeds. And there I was, holding on to babies who are the manifestation of abandonment. So while I am not saying that it is the fault of the women, I am saying that we have responsibility. We are the ones who give them kitty cat when they don't deserve it. We are the ones who are raising these men to be overly emotional and super duper sensitive. So While most men don't have the emotional capacity to join you in the fight to raising your child, it is not up to him. Because at the end of the day, you know what they used to say, mama's baby, daddy's baby. So to my sisters, we got a responsibility out here, not just to parent ours, but to assist somebody in parenting theirs, because sometimes they need to be raised here. We didn't all get raised. That's all I got.